An excerpt from the journal of Sage Arcadius. The humans of Orin, the elves of Malinor, the orcs of Krugmar, and the dwarfs of Calaguain. Each race, each nation has been affected in some way by the relentless attacks of the undead. Orin, most of all, with its close proximity to the north. Snowy fields, decimated. Halcyon lies in ruins. What is perhaps more troublesome is that the undead have even found their way past Orin and have launched multiple attacks on the capital of the orcs. Despair, fear, hopelessness. I see it all around me. Many have lost faith and have turned to the dark ways of Iblis. Others have simply turned a blind eye towards it. But we ascended have not. In order to address the threat of the undead in the north, my brothers and I summoned Ariel's keep to assist Orin in its military efforts to fight back the undead. The followers of Ariel, who make their home at the keep, assist us with this duty valiantly. Although we have fought many battles and been victorious in most, the war has taken a heavy toll on our forces, not excluding myself. I have not let my mental state affect my service, though. With Maiaville's medicine and Sue's magical intervention, my condition has become somewhat manageable. I continue to grow weary, though. When the brave and noble armies of Aegis rallied together and destroyed the undead keep near Snowy Fields, we prayed that the undead would discontinue their siege on the north. In a manner, our prayers were answered. The undead have gone into hiding, but their corruption still runs deep. They whisper from the shadows, they strike, then disappear. How can you fight your enemy when your enemy becomes nothing but smoke in your hands? This change in the undead's tactics has proven quite troublesome. Instead of putting themselves in harm's way, they instead choose to bring down nations through deceit, corruption, and lies, and by using our own people against us. We ascended have grown stronger, though. We are not as weak as we once were. With the discovery of the relics of the angels, we now stand a proper chance against the undead. Although it is rumored that the golden axe of Malcadia lies in the clutches of the undead, they cannot keep it from us forever. Ariel has blessed us with many new ascendants, skilled in the ways of tracking down the taints of Iblis. It is only a matter of time. War is on the horizon. Our scouts have recently discovered what we believe to be an undead stronghold in the south. We have begun our preparations and hope to attack the undead installation very soon. With a bit of luck, we might be able to obtain the golden axe of Malcadia as well. The only way we can prove to be successful in this endeavor, though, is if the nations of Aegis, with their military might, choose to stand with the Ascendant once more against the undead, as they have done so valiantly in the past.